Hi guys, it's Sophie. Welcome back to our channel. Let's make some recovery journals. So as you can probably tell from the title of this video, I'm going to be showing you how to make some journals that can help you in your recovery or that can help you if you're in treatment. First, I'm going to show you what my recovery journals look like. I made these when I was in treatment. I found them extremely helpful. I have two different kinds. That's four. I have two different kinds. I made this recovery tracking journal where I tracked how every day was in treatment for me, and I continued to do this for a bit when I was discharged from treatment and when I got home. And the second type of journal I have is more of a bullet journal of things that help keep me going and some skills and also some fun little things and quotes and things like that. So let's get started. The first thing, this is what it looks like. I've got a bunch of them actually. I like to make my own notebooks, and I can do a whole tutorial on how to make your own notebooks. It's pretty damn straightforward. I'm gonna first show you what my journals look like, and then I'm going to take you through how to make them, how to use them. Let's jump right in. Dive right into the topic. Submerge ourselves into the journals. Dig our way through our to-do, which is this video. Something that you're going to need, or at least in my opinion, are stickers. This is coming from me, the sticker addict. I have a problem. I have an obsession. Yes, I am an adult, but you gotta love stickers. Come on now. I actually, in treatment, put together this box of stickers, and each little individual box in the box, each individual compartment has different types of stickers that I took the time to cut out and organize. I had a lot of time. You got a lot of time on your hands when you're in treatment for an eating disorder. Most of these stickers have motivational little statements on them. Rock-ons, or these are my favorite. I finished my, can you see that? I finished my lunch. What a great sticker to have. Well, the first thing you're going to need for your recovery journals or trackers, you might call them journals or trackers, you know what, whatever floats your goat, is a notebook. Obviously. When we open up mine, I've just covered this because it's the name of the treatment center that I was at. EDP stands for Eating Disorders Program, if you're wondering. And the next page, I wrote down a bunch of quotes that I found helpful. We've got kind of a cover page. Make it fun for yourself. So the way this tracker kind of went, what I would do is I would pre-prepare these pages, and I'm gonna show you how to do it. But I got the date, and I would write how much my eating disorder was affecting me that morning, my feelings and thoughts. I had a section for each meal and snack of the day. I would write down how anxious I was feeling about it, how much I struggled, if I went in with a positive attitude. And then if I finished my meal with no behaviors, I gave myself a sticker. I also have a mood tracker on each day. Bedtime thoughts at the very end, just things that I was feeling, things I wanted to get out of my head before I went to bed. So in my bullet journal was less of a means of tracking and more of a thing to turn to when I was struggling, a way of distracting myself, because I love to bullet journal. There's not much in here. So I tracked my days at treatment, menu stickers. These ones here are snack stickers. On our daily snacks, when we went to get them, we would have our name like this on a little sticker so that we could find our snacks. And then when we would do menu selections for the week, some of us would put stickers on our menus so that our menus were easier to find when we went into the dining room. So I always peeled mine off my menu and saved them on my sticker page. This one's a little pointless, but because I love stickers, cute stickers. This is probably the most important page or pages. This actually came from a booklet that I found on the table in our dining room slash lounge that one of my amazing co-patients made. And it was a little booklet called Mealtime Coping. I think that it should go in your recovery journal. The next page, I think I wrote this in September, so it was like my September currents. So I said, currently I was reading The Goblet of Fire, I was watching Grey's Anatomy, talking a lot to my friend Harry, eating, and by eating I mean I was eating a lot of these foods that I wouldn't otherwise have eaten, so foods that were new to me and that I was eating a lot of in treatment. At that time it was bran, soy milk, and salad dressing. Trying. I didn't write anything here, but I should have, because I was trying a lot of things in treatment. Drawing. At that time I was drawing a co-patient of mine, a portrait, and I was also drawing a portrait of Mary Rose Howley, which I will show here. She's my favorite and Bella's favorite YouTuber. And I was knitting a scarf. Thank you, Mom, if you're watching this, for saying you loved my shitty scarf. Ah, now this is a good one. Distractions. Distractions are very important and very good to have in your coping mechanism toolbox, let's call it. Because there are times, especially when you're in crisis, when sometimes you can't use your skills that you know because things are just too bad or you're in too much distress. So this is the time to distract. I tested out, we had this big wheel of gel pens, this tower of gel pens that one of the co-patients brought in, and I love them because I love using them to make my colorful journals. So I tested out all the gel pens. Now this page is all about emotions. Each emotion has a prompting event, an interpretation, biology, charge, expression, action, and after effect. This page is full of different categories of emotions and words that fall into those categories. I think it's really important to have a good vocabulary of emotion words because then it makes it easier to express how you're feeling. So that's a great thing to have in your journal. I think it's a good idea to find things that make you happy or that represent things that make you happy and add them into your journal, because then on a bad day you can look at them and think about that happy memory. So here I'm just going to show you in more detail what the journals look like and show you how to make them. Also, this is irrelevant, but let me just show you because I like it. This is my little workspace. Got a bunch of little things going here. This is a meme that is one of my favorite memes ever that Bella sent me when I was in treatment. She sent me this whole envelope of memes, which cheered me up so much. So we open.
Just whistle while you work, and cheerfully together we can tidy up the place. So I'm a merry tune. It won't take long when there's a song to help.
Okay, so I've kind of outlined in pencil just so that I don't write crooked, because I can't write on a blank piece of paper and not have it be crooked. I used to go in with my pencil and then go over it, but let's dive right in with the markers. So let's start with our date. Now I like to make a scale of my level of, I call it level of ED fuckery, which means how much my eating disorder is messing with my brain on a particular day on some sort of scale. I think that's helpful so that I can go back and see how I reacted to that and what helped me and didn't help me. So since it's the morning, I'm gonna go ahead and fill this in for my day. Thank you for watching my video, you guys. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and let us know if you want to see more videos like this, and we'll see you when we see you. Bye, everyone. That was a really awkward hand motion. I don't know what that was. It was like an almost wave. Bye, everyone.